is Erez Zadok. I'm a professor of computer science, and I wanted to tell you briefly about a presentation I made recently for the graduate students of computer science. So I've always felt that once an advisor, always an advisor, and I've helped my own students over the years while they were here and even after they graduated. I always found it interesting that students spend between 1 and 5 years here, and then the rest of their careers, decades, outside the university setting, usually in industry. And so it is very important, I thought, in my opinion, to help the students prepare for life outside university, and also to get the best possible internships and jobs that they can. It's important for the students' success, it's important for the economy of the country, it's also important for the reputation of the university, the department, the college. But I found out over the years that students had a lot of inexperience. They just didn't know how to go about getting jobs, how to interview, what to say, what not to say. And there's also a lot of cultural differences. Students come from many different backgrounds and countries from all over the world, and sometimes those cultural differences stood in the way of them getting the best possible job. And so, based on my experience, I prepared a presentation that covers sort of three parts of how to get summer internships and jobs in general. The first part is, what do you do before? How do you prepare? How do you get your CV ready? How to study and prepare for these interviews? The second part is, what do you do during the interviews? They're usually multi-phased interviews. They start with phone, and then they follow usually with some sort of a video interview. And then finally, there's in-person interviews. And finally, what do you do after you're done with interviews and you start to get offers? How do you negotiate, when to negotiate, how much to negotiate, how to weigh in the many different aspects of an offer that you get and pick the one that is most suitable for you? And finally, I also advise students that I'm happy to help them even years afterward, sometimes several years later. They're considering a career move, maybe moving from a big company to a startup or vice versa, and they want my advice, and I'm happy to help them. So I hope you find this video useful and enjoy. So let's start with before you apply, what you have to do before. So there's a few things you have to do, and one of the first things is simply update your resume or curriculum vitae or CV. There's a lot of things that I've seen in CVs that are just not right, missing, you know, things that you've gotten advice from various sources. You can ask your advisor, you can ask other people who have had experience. The order of the items in your resume matters, because the people who read them have tons of resumes to read, and if they don't get excited about your resume from the first beginning or the first page, then they're just going to skip through it and put it aside. So think about what's more important for the person that reads it. What do we do during the interviews? It's okay to take some notes. You may not remember everything that happens in an interview, especially if you have a bunch of interviews spanning weeks and then they go into second rounds and third rounds. You're not going to remember everything. So take some notes, okay? That will help you to refresh your mind. Who said what? With whom did I speak? What products are we talking about? Because after a while, everything seems a little hazy. Listen carefully to the questions. The questions sometimes are not phrased the best way. If you don't understand, ask them what exactly they mean. One way that's very useful in just plain communications with people is if you repeat the question in your own words to the person who asked you. And if they say, yes, that's what I meant, now you know that you understood their question properly. Otherwise, you might be answering the wrong question. Even if they phrased it, you know, a little bit awkwardly, but they think, they didn't understand me. There's something's wrong with them. How do you handle negotiating? Okay. So if you only have one offer, in some ways it's easy, right? You don't have much of a choice. You either take that offer or stay in school longer. Actually, it's not such a bad idea to stay in school longer, because you'll be surprised what one more semester in school, what it can do to your offers. In just 4 months later. If you have multiple offers, and I think many of you will, go and speak to your advisor.
about these offers. Usually he or she will have some good idea about the companies in question. They might have some insight into this company is on the rise, this company is not doing so well, or there's something wrong with this one, or something really good about this one. As I said before, consider the entire package, including, you know, all the extra benefits and the location and everything when you consider which offer you might take. So negotiate with each company once, get an extension once, that's okay. But if you do more than that, that starts to look a little fishy. And you should resist the pressure to accept the offers too early. And companies sometimes will call you very early, you know, repeatedly. How do you like it? Do you have any more questions? Have you decided? Have you decided? Have you decided? Why? Because they have a set number of people they need to hire. And if they hire you, they put a check mark on that position. They're done. They don't have to worry anymore about hiring that position. Now they need to fill in the other positions.